everybody's Lance. This is Lance Henson with Combine Harvester Thrashers, and welcome to today's live. You read the title. Will a grain bin work for a tree stand? As you can see, I got my new toy here. We're going to check it out. We've got a little target down here, and I do please forgive me because I haven't shot a gun for a long time. It's not because I don't love shooting guns. I don't have any time to shoot guns. When you're in the middle of a farm show, that's not necessarily like it's really an option. But got a little target down here. It's called a hard hat right there. So you guys can see hard hat. Now that is a junk hard hat. And we're going to see if we can hit it from the whole way up here with this bad boy. It is a 7mm 08, and we're gonna see what we can hit from up here. So here goes. We're gonna see if we can pull this off. So let me get up. Please excuse me for a little bit. Hopefully nothing goes bad here, but we're gonna get propped up here. Let's get her done. I got my game on.
Out of the shower, steaming up the place. Wipe off the mirror, shave my baby face. Can't help but smile. Hey, what can I say? I got my game on. Put on my black silk shirt, my Armani suit, my custom made hat, my alligator boots. Slip my rings on my fingers, my new shades.
You won't believe it. I had it first shot. Oh, dang it. Oh, that was fun. Oh, yes. That is freaking awesome.
Yeah, bought it.
See if we can do that again.
Game on.
I think I missed it that time.
That little hottie at the bar just gave me a wink. Flashed my platinum card and buy her a drink. From that look she's giving me, son, it's a damn good thing. I got my game on.
Woo! I hopefully hit it. And just when you thought I grew up just a little bit, we can find this right here. Just when you thought I grew up, just a little bit.
I can't believe this. I just hit that thing. I don't know how far that is, right of a shot that is. At least I think it did. The helmet moved. Either I hit it right beside it or I hit right on. I'm not going to try it again because it was really loud. But, oh boy. I'm going to swing that around. Sorry about that, folks. All my excitement and everything. But check this thing out. We're going to go shoot one of these things out of here. So let's see how this works. Sorry about this, folks. Hold that there. Yeah, buddy. That doesn't really work. Okay, let's run down here real quick and let's check and see if we even hit this thing. This is going to be pretty awesome. I'm pretty excited. Good 7M08 just to see if we actually hit anything or not. I'm pretty psyched. It's pretty rare that you hit something for the first time from that far and you haven't shot a gun in like a year. That's pretty impressive. I kind of doubt I hit it. I probably hit like right beside it and made it fly. But, and by the way, kids, do not try this ever, 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 ever. I will kick your rear end so hard if I ever catch you kids doing this. I am a professional. Do not do this. The police are probably going to come out, throw me in jail, and I don't want to see your mama see you kids in jail. So, do not do this. I am a professional. I'm the only crazy guy one hand shooting a 7mm short barrel stock off top of a 54-foot Sioux grain bin and trying to hit a hard hat from, I don't know, probably, I don't know, probably 50 yards or something like that. Wasn't that far, but far enough to be like, woohoo! I'll have to measure it out sometime to get a viewfinder or something like that. But let's see if I actually hit this hard hat. It'll be insane if I actually hit it. I mean, I could not believe that it flew the first time. And maybe I'm just overexcited or whatever. I'll get down here. I was like 2 yards off. But if we actually hit this from this far, like, I just can't believe that this is... Oh, this is so excited. Let's actually see if I actually hit this with my 7mm. If I did... this is just crazy. And to be honest with you guys, actually, I do have to be honest. I think I took this gun out yesterday evening and I didn't even try it. And it was dark outside just to see how big of a fireball it threw. I did shoot it last night. But that being said, I wasn't really trying to hit anything with it. Let's see it. The helmet is right out here, really close, right beside that mud puddle. Let's see if I actually hit it. I'm thinking if I did actually hit it, it would have actually like blown a hole in it. Oh, it's close. It's close. Let's see how close we actually were. Okay, I was right. That did not actually hit the helmet. Okay, I'm that's great. Okay. That's good. That's real good. But here, this dirt clump is where I was, and that's where I hit, right there. So, that far away, that far off, the whole way up there. Will a grain bin work as a tree stand? Possibly. Not recommended at all. Not recommended at all. It's pretty sweet. Just the look, you guys can see right there. I mean, right there. Let's point this out again. Right there, where my hole's at, right here, and that's where the helmet's at. So yeah, I didn't hit it. And by the way, I'm not saying that I'm a sharpshooter by any chance. If I hit anything, I'm pretty lucky. Beautiful grain bins out here tonight. If you're logging in right now, please like this video, share this video. Yes, I'm not a sharpshooter. I accidentally hit things every once in a while because the second time I shot down there, I was nowhere near. Now, I'm not saying if I sat there for a couple hours and held the gun and shaked a lot, I couldn't hit something else again, but that's beside the point. But that's pretty awesome. Hey, watch this. Not only can I run a real sweet gun, I'll show you a little trick here. Yeah, right there. You saw it. Can even twirl the thing. Real sweet gun. My friend of mine sold it to me. Pretty sweet gun. But yeah, grain business has been great today. We got 2 loads of corded. Tomorrow I think I'm getting a load of conventional soybeans. This time it's kind of slow time of the year. So we're fixing up the office, getting it all ready to go. Because we love to have fun this time of the year and get things ahead, get bearings fixed and electric motors like this one right here. That electric motor's out because the bearings went bad in it. Simple things like getting new wooden tables in the offices for the grain testers and the dockage scales. That's another big thing on the list. The day I ordered a pulley, an SK pulley, because I had too small of a one on my auger drive, so it was spinning it way too fast and enough torque. But yeah, that's kind of what I've been up to. Crazy and wild as always. And yes, I was gonna do it beforehand. These are the earplugs. Yes, kids, you're supposed to wear earplugs when you do something like this. So, here's my beautiful table. It's still, you might think it's crazy, but this thing is still drying. However, since long I've been, like right here, it's still like that's something stuck in my one employee came in here and stuffed his finger into it and it was still soft there. So it takes a while for tables like that to draw dry down. But yes, if you were watching the Facebook Live, that was pretty awesome. That was impressive. And I do have to say, I'm like, to hit that close to a hard hat that far away, I'm happy with that. No way, shape, or form that I'm a sharpshooter. But yeah, so there you go, guys. Go join our group. Check out the community side of the page. Check out the pages that we're connected with. And go to our timeline and check out our videos, because we make some pretty awesome videos and a whole bunch of other cool stuff. See y'all later. Keep on farming. Here's Facebook Poker.